everybody. I'm Lauren, and today I decided to go ahead and do So Loud's 20 quarantine costumer questions, something like that. And I decided to go ahead and do it in my Edwardian undies because we're locked down. I have nowhere to go, but I still want to look pretty. So I have written down my 20 questions. What was your first costume? This is a great question. My very first costume was back in the dark ages, around 2005. I made that awful, awful Simplicity Regency gown. And that was the gown that was my very first, like, I want to get into this time period and sew and learn how to do this. It was terrible. As you can see. What is your favorite costume you have ever made? This one's a lot of fun. Actually, I just made it for Carnival. We had decided that we were going to do a group costume, and we usually do a few of them when we travel together. So this time we had decided that we wanted to do pink and green 18th century, and that's that kind of pastel-y pinks and greens. And it could be any time within the 18th century, any style you wanted, as long as it matched the colors. Found my fabric, and I was going to go for an Italian style, because it's going to wear in Italy. And I did not know how I wanted to trim it, until I found this painting. Right? So I had to do it. I hated my life while I was making it. You will find out why later on. But I rolled those hems, I did it, and I'm really pleased with the results. Number three, what costume do you dream of making? I love, 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 love Victorian and Edwardian burlesque costumes. I think they are so much fun. I've made one, which I'll show you later on. They're fun to make, they're fun to wear, and they're so ridiculously silly. I would love to make more of them. If I ever go back to Carnival, don't know when, if I ever do, maybe that will be something I'll delve into. It's definitely kind of my alter ego. Question number four, what is a sewing task you love and a sewing task you hate? Let's start with the hate. As I mentioned before, pink and green organza floof monster. I hate rolling hems. Love the results of it. It's beautiful. I hate the process. It is tedious. It takes forever. It's so worth it. I love the building of bodices. I don't know what it is about bodices. They're so much fun to build for most time periods. I'm not a big fan of setting sleeves, but I'm getting better at it. I do find that as I get into later time periods, sleeve setting becomes so much easier. But yeah, I love building bodices. So fun to watch the fit, watch everything kind of come together and take the vision that's been all up in my brain and swarming around and making it a reality. Question number five. Guys, hey, the pack's back. We have Daisy again, and now Sybil, the bulldog, which you can't see. Come on, go, go, go. Would I rather sew with silk or with wool? It really depends on the project, and that's unfortunately gonna be a lot of my answers. I love the crispness of silk, but it's not very forgiving, where wool is very, very forgiving. So if you make a mistake, you can kind of fudge it and no one will really know. The other cool thing about wool is it's wonderful for the elements. It's great in summer for lightweight wool. It's great in winter when it's cold. It's great for rain gear. It's really kind of a very versatile all-around fabric. Number six, would you rather go to a themed event or pick my own theme? I love themed events. There's something so immersive when everybody's in the same time period, the same style of costume, the music's involved. It just transports you to another time, another place. That being said, non-themed events can be a lot of fun because you see a lot of creativity, but if I had a preference, I'm themed all day long. Number seven, would you rather go to a big ball or an intimate dinner? Oh, this question is so unfair. I'm an extrovert, if you haven't figured out by now. I love talking, I love mingling, I love being around people, I love meeting new people. It's big parties, they are my favorite. But right now, I'm just really missing my friends. So I would go for an intimate dinner with my closest friends any second. I miss you guys. Mm-hmm. You all know who you are. Number 8. Do you prefer to hand sew or machine sew? Hand sew. 100%. That being said, I am learning machine sewing. I'm self-taught. I have actually never really taken a sewing class besides a couple of embroidery workshops. I feel like I have so much more control with hand sewing. I also started in making time periods that were pre-sewing machine. I started with 1790s and 18th century. So that makes sense on how those are constructed. That works for my brain. Sewing machines are scary. However, I'm wearing stuff that I've machine sewn. So I'm getting there. As I'm delving into Edwardian, I'm really learning how to use my machine, how to do some more tricks on it, using techniques that I've learned from hand sewing, like basting your hands to get nice, fine, tiny hems, and also being able to translate to the machine. So that's kind of really cool. But I still love that cathartic hand sewing. I can plop on the couch, grab my bird, grab a dog, watch a film, and just sew away. Number 9, do you prefer wigs, hair pieces, or your own hair? I actually do a combination of hair pieces and my own hair. What I'm wearing now is a cushion by Jenny LaFleur, and the kind of bun on top, which you might be able to see, is actually a hair fall that Jenny LaFleur matched to my hair color. So I definitely am a fan of both, of the combination. I'm not a big fan of wigs. I run warm, my head gets hot. I also have long hair, and so it just, if I can, I will weave my own hair into hair pieces. Let's see here. Number 5, name 5 small costume businesses. Well, I just named Jenny LaFleur. seriously, hair pieces, tutorials, she's the one to go to. Red Threaded, I'm actually wearing the Red Threaded Espen. Yes, I can breathe, ladies and gentlemen. I can move, I can kick my legs up, I can do Dames All in Mode. Sparklies. Willoughby and Rose, she makes all my shifts, and you're gonna see some of them later on. An American Duchess, my shoes are American Duchess, as you can see here. I have a shoe problem, a jewelry problem, a corset problem, a shift problem, a hair problem. I don't see them as problems. I can quit anytime I want. So it's raining today, and my pets are super hyper. Name 5 YouTube channels that we should check out. I really love Crow's Eye Productions. They do some great historical dressing, clothing, hair, makeup tutorials, as well as just some beautiful shots. Dames All in Mode, So Loud, prompted all of this fun that we're doing. Jenny LaFleur, she's got some great tutorials and a lot of really cool content that's coming. And Willoughby and Rose, she just recently started her channel. What is my favorite color? I love blues and greens. Ugh. Although, I've been sewing with a lot of pink lately. Pink, 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 pink. I know, right? But still, blues, greens are my go-to. I definitely have cooler skin tones, so they definitely work for me. Pearls or sparkles? Ugh. Sparkles. Guys, I love shiny things. So yeah, sparkles. But I do love a good pearl. When I'm doing something more simple, depending on the time period, if I were wearing day dress over this, I would totally be wearing pearls with Edwardian. Number 14, what is a costume trip you've dreamed of taking? Oh, I hope beyond hope that this happens. So guys, we've been planning this trip for 2 years now. We're planning to go to Prince Edward Island in Canada. Yeah, I was obsessed with Anne of Green Gables from the time I can remember. My mom read me the books. We taped the miniseries off of TV, and I wore those tapes into the ground. Some point, I will show you my sewing room and take you on a tour of my bookshelf and my poor, sad, worn, loved to bits Anne of Green Gables novels that I have read cover to cover. I love them. So I'm really hoping that this trip happens, that I can take you guys on this journey with us. I don't know. I'm sewing as though it will. We'll see. What is your favorite cocktail? I love a good Pimm's Cup. The Blue Talon guys in Williamsburg makes the best Pimm's Cups. They're so good. I also love a good Moscow Mule. I like both. It just kind of depends on what kind of mood I'm in. Who is a costumer that you would love to meet? This is actually kind of a cool question, because I actually got to meet somebody in Venice this year that I have been wanting to meet for years. Her name's Elisa, and she has a blog called Isis Wardrobe. She and I have been acquaintances online for probably 15 years now, and we've never actually got a chance to meet. And finally this year we got to meet, and she is as delightful in person as she is online. So Elisa, if you're listening to this, you're somebody I really wanted to meet, and I'm so glad we finally got to. It was great. Number 17, do you prefer plain or patterned fabric? That's a tough one. I've done both. I tend to stick with more stripes. However, as I'm kind of delving into embroidery, I'm going to be looking at some more patterned fabrics that I might be using for day wear, wearing around the house, that sort of thing. I do like the play of patterned fabrics. They're a lot of fun. That being said, I'm kind of simple in my wardrobe and what I wear, which sounds really weird. I know, wearing silks. But as far as the styles that I go for more streamlined looks in my wardrobes. And you'll see in my Edwardian, stripes, you know, was a big thing. And I have used stripes from my 18th century. I don't tend to really do a lot of florally things. I tend to add interest on the back end with trim, with lace, with that sort of thing. But I would like to, you know, sew more with patterns. So we'll see what I can come up with. Number 18, do you use a pattern or do you make your own? This is a great question. I get this question all the time on my Instagram. And honestly, it's a combination of both. So, as you can see, I'm gonna stand up, show you. I am very curvy. Very curvy. So, I'm also very short-waisted. So, you might be able to see. That's my waist, kids. There it is. I can't use regular commercial patterns as they come. I can't. I have to alter absolutely everything to fit a deep curve and a short waist. I sometimes will use patterns just to kind of get the idea of shapes, but I actually find that books help me a lot more. So for Edwardian, I'm using The Voice of Fashion by Frances Grimble. I really love Janet Arnold, although sometimes Janet Arnold makes you ask more questions than answers, but you'll get some great shapes. And then just really looking at paintings, looking at, if the time period allows, photographs, videos, if you can find them, looking at what other costumers are doing. I really do find that draping patterns for me, for my body, works so much better than using a commercial pattern. If I buy a commercial pattern, it's really to get like a sleeve shape, because I hate drafting sleeves with passion. Almost as much as I hate rolling hems. But if I can, I will use pattern for like just a sleeve shape. But really, I have developed my own patterns over years and years. I have my dress form padded within an inch of its life so that I can actually drape on it. Definitely prefer not using a pattern and making my own. I do, once I have a pattern that I like, keep it. So I draft them out, drape them, cut them out, trace them. I'm very big on keeping the patterns that I make so that when I need to do a new time period, I can say, huh, I really like that 18th century sleeve. I wonder if it can translate to this time period because the shape is similar, and then I'll adjust it according to what images I find. So that's how my brain works. Number 19, what is my favorite era to wear? Okay, so this isn't really an era more than it is a costume. I love Can Can Girl. Victorian Portrait Studio, Dave Wilson, came to this event that we had. Did tintypes for me as Can Can Girl. I was actually following an original portrait of a woman who was known as La Goulou, and she was kind of the belle of the Moulin Rouge, and she was painted by La Tourette and very well known, and she ended up, you know, alcoholism and dying of liver cirrhosis in like the 1920s and 30s. Dirt poor, she kept a tiger as a pet. Fascinating person. But in her fame, in her height, she was the it girl. So I saw this photo and I had to recreate it. So that is by far my favorite costume to wear. I don't know if you really call it an era, but oh, and yeah, it's so much fun. Last but certainly not least, some of you already know this. What is one thing you don't know about me? I do pole dancing. That is my other hobby. Probably why I absolutely love Victorian burlesque costumes. I've been doing it now for about 2 years. I don't know if I'm great at it, but it's a really good exercise. Gives me a really good creative outlet. I need that creative outlet, and I'm really big into moving my body. I need to move. I need to exercise. It hurts, but it's so much fun, guys. I hope you guys are doing well, and I'm not sure what I'm going to release next. Still kind of formulating some ideas. If you have some ideas for what you'd like to see, pop down below. Leave me a comment. I would love to hear from you. And feel free to also follow me on Instagram. Have a great day, guys. Ugh, words are hard.